is KCAA.
Look, ain't no time to be down and out. Tune in to the things to be proud about. When you sacrifice and reach your goal, you can look back around and laugh it out. You know the station that's so amazing. Need inspiration and motivation. When you're in your mind with nowhere to go, well then welcome to the Matt Rock Show.
Welcome to the show, everybody tuning in on the radio here, local in the Inland Empire on 1050 AM. 106.5 FM and now 102.3 FM. This is NBC News Radio, KCAA Radio. And if you are watching live on KCAARadio.com or via the MattRockShow.com, we want to say hello. And we hope that you spend and really enjoy the next hour of your Monday evening, or if you're watching the recorded version on the MattRockShow.com, season one episodes anytime. We hope that you really just enjoy this time. So my name is Matt Rock. I am your host of the Matt Rock Show. And tonight is quite entertaining. We're definitely going to be having some fun here on the mic tonight. I got me Familia in the house with me, and my special guests tonight are Eli Garcia and April Garcia. I am so honored and grateful that you're both on the show with me. So I want to introduce you guys, and thank you so much for being here. How are you both doing tonight?
Hey, we're doing great, man. Thank you. It's an honor to be here. We thank you very much for having us here. And you know, baby girl, it's the best in this world. We're having you in our lives, man. So thank you.
Thank you so much for inviting us. This is fun. Both of us together should be lots and lots of fun.
Yeah, this is going to be great. So tonight what we're going to be doing is we're going to be starting the show off with our Solid Rock segment. And by the way, we hope that if you are listening on the radio, if you want to get a taste of our visual flow and energy, we want to encourage you to go over to kcaaradio.com or themattrockshow.com/next episode, and you can actually join in on this visual energy, and you can watch this show live or, of course, recorded under season one episodes. So we're going to be having some fun. We hope that you feel very much so a part of this energy, this show. You guys are going to be so fun and hard to work with tonight.
Because you know us so well, man. That's the problem.
Yeah.
We've been with this part of the family for years, and just having us here together, it's a lot, man. You guys got to be careful when around this guy with our family, because he's, you know, like my little baby girl, my little sister.
Oh, man.
Hermanita.
It's not what it sounds like.
No, it's really not. It's really not. Eli's just nervous, and he's trying to get rid of
he
the
is.
Stress.
Hey, you said that we have to be on the show to fight one of our biggest fears, right? And one of my biggest fears is being myself in live radio. And ooh, whoever's listening in, you know, I'm doing the best that I can. But as you'll see with my body language, as you'll see in the video,
he
that I'm moving a lot.
Shuts down.
I kind of shut down a little bit. So,
but he's tons of fun.
So we're going to jump into the facing of fears a little bit later. So that's actually going to be a part of our Solid Rock Talk segment, which we'll kick off in just a moment. That's pretty much where we go through a book that has really impacted my life. It's a part of my library. I take pride in having a library of personal development books that help me achieve greater success in my life and personally develop myself. Anyway, we want to share that value with you. We're going to dive into a few of our quotes that we really love and enjoy, and we want to speak on that, kind of get a little motivational. Speaking of motivation, the Matt Rock Show intentionally and started off as a motivation project that we want to share all across the world. Now, we're here locally in San Bernardino, the Inland Empire. But the Matt Rock Show vision is that we can uplift, inspire, empower, motivate, and encourage and support so many people, especially our younger generation, especially millennials, right?
Yeah, we need that.
Definitely. And to do that for them all across the world, not just here in the Inland Empire, but there's internet everywhere you go in the world, and anybody can watch the show. So if at any given moment in time you find something about the show that you enjoy, that you like, make sure that you share on your social media pages, your Snapchat, your Facebook, Instagram, tag Matthew Rock, Eli, April, and the Matt Rock Show, and share with your friends and family. So tonight is, we're going to have a little bit of motivation in here. We definitely will. On top of that, though, this is the most entertaining, dynamic, and motivational talk show in 2017. So you're definitely going to get a dose of entertainment tonight. So after our Solid Rock Talk segment, we are going to have a new fun game that I just created today. It should be a good time.
Woo-woo.
I like to call it Sing or Sink. So we're going to dive into that soon. And after that, we might have some fun with some Chuck Norris jokes, maybe if we have time. That was a last-minute idea. But let's go ahead and dive into Solid Rock Talk. So like I said, Solid Rock Talk is where we take a book that's a part of my personal development library. We want to share the value that it has to share. Now, we can't do this book complete justice. What we want to encourage you do is if you appreciate or find value in anything that we have to share with you, go check it out on Barnes & Noble or Amazon or wherever you want to get this book. So it is called Do One Thing Every Day That Scares You. And it's a journal. Every page has a different quote by a different author, whether known or unknown. It's very fun, very dynamic, very artistic. And we each have actually chosen a couple quotes that we want to dive into. And please feel free to take your time. We're going to go ahead and start off with April. What is one of your quotes that you really enjoy from this book as you were scrolling through it earlier? Go ahead and read it and the author, and then just really speak on why that is impactful for you. Take your time.
It was hard. It was really hard to pick out a quote from this book because there's so many great quotes that I like. But the ones that spoke to me today, the first one was, "The greatest test of courage on earth is to bear defeat without losing heart." And the person who said this was Robert G. Ingersoll. One of the reasons that it really spoke to me is because there's so many things that can happen in life that can make you feel defeated, right? When you do something or you try to do something and you fail, or you see things happening in your life that you don't understand, you kind of get to a point where you want to lose heart, you know, you want to feel defeated. But the best thing to do is to push through that, you know, to rise above it, to become better, because that not only does that test yourself as a person, but it makes your fear lessen and your courage grow. And that's where success comes from, is not being afraid to leap out in courage. Even if you're scared, even if you're fearful, you still do it. And sometimes you will find the most amazing things at the end of that. So that really spoke to me. That was one. So I'll let Eli take the next one.
And one more time before Eli goes, what was that quote one more time, just to finish it out, to state it again?
The greatest test of courage on earth is to bear defeat without losing heart. Robert G. Ingersoll said that.
It's beautiful. Thank you. All right, Eli, what you got?
Well, the quote that I picked was, "The artist never entirely knows. We guess. We may be wrong, but we take a leap after we leap in the dark." That's by Agnes DeMille. Now, the reason why I picked this quote is because, I mean, I'm an artist at heart. You know, I'm very sensitive. I draw. I love to act. Those would be my hobbies. And when it comes to an artist, you know, a lot of people try to judge us, saying that we're too extreme, that we don't really necessarily pay attention to detail, that we're too sensitive, that we don't take light of the situation. But here's the thing. As an artist, that's how we take chances. We make mistakes. We go through all these different things in our lives. We guess, and we're not sure ourselves. That's why we have to take these chances, that leap of faith in the dark, because we don't know the outcome. And through my own life experiences, I mean, these, for example, right now, I'm going through a little bit of anxiety just being here on the radio. But however, I'm overcoming this, being here with my brother, with my sister on live radio.
Yeah, you're killing it, Hermanita.
And for me to just tell the other people, you know, what I would tell you guys is this, is at these moments that you feel that you're going through these hard times, that you're going through these, you know, social anxiety, whatever the case that you guys are going through, take that leap of faith. Because here's the only thing, even if you hit rock bottom, the only way for you to get up is, you know, straight up. That's how you guys get yourself through these situations. You have to look at yourself and realize you're your own motivation. You don't need anybody else to get you to where you need to be. So, you know, that quote one more time is, "The artist never entirely knows. We guess. We may be wrong, but we take a leap after we leap in the dark," by Agnes DeMille.
I didn't know that a couple motivational speakers were coming on the Matt Rock Show tonight. What's up, guys? Over here facing fears, being on the air live and on video. It's kind of like a fun TV show. And by the way, you said in the quote, "The artist." I know you yourself, Eli, before we get to my quote, I know you are quite the artist. I know you've done a little bit of art. Could you briefly share on what kind of art that you partake in, why that excites you? And I just kind of want to spend a moment to highlight you and your talents, man. You're a very artistic young man, and that inspires me about you, amongst other things.
Well, for me as an artist, the way that I do like drawing is I'm more into caricatures, more like into animation. So I do love drawing Disney. I'm trying to do anime, which is not that great, but I'm still going to try. And my motivation for art is mostly this. You know, a lot of times people are going through stress, they're going through anxiety, and a lot of people run away through the normal things, which would be what? Alcohol, you know, drugs, whatever the case may be. My way of escaping all of that is my art. So when I'm stressed at work, when I'm stressed with my life, I take that moment to use that energy into something to make it beautiful. And a lot of the things that you guys can see through my Instagram, it would be at ELI4280. That's where you guys would be able to see some of the pieces that I've done. And the way that I feel that I do with my art pieces is that although for me, I'm going through a hard time, I'm depressed, I'm frustrated, whatever the case may be, through that frustration, I create beauty, and I give it out to my friends, to my family, and I let it go. That's how I deal with my stress, is that it's a healthy way for me to not allow all these circumstances to get to me. And that's the reason why I do art. You know, my way of speaking through art, through other people, is that whatever they're going through, I give them that little piece of motivation. Like one of my closest friends at work, you know, she was going through a hard time, and she asked me, hey, Eli, can you draw me something nice? She liked the unicorn, and you'll see this on my Instagram.
Oh, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I was jealous, and I wanted to keep it.
And you know, and what I did with this piece was like, okay, I'll keep it very simple. She said she liked the color purple, and I did it very simple, and it took me forever. And here's the thing, I'm very critical about my work, so I did it like 4 or 5 different times. So after I did that, I finally gave her the final piece, and she loves it, and it's in her desk at the office. But here's the thing, you know, my only thing that I tell you guys out in the audience, if you guys are artists, whatever your motivation may be, continue doing it. Don't let anybody strive you or put you down, because here's the thing, that's what we do. That's not what anybody else does. They're jealous of our work. You know, some of us want to be a model or an actress, and they're so scared to go out that extra mile. Or even like Matthew right here, my brother, my hermanita, he has his own show now. You know, he's been doing this for weeks, and he's doing a great job at it. And for us, we have to continue that drive to always move forward, no matter the circumstances around us. So my only advice to you is press on. If you guys feel that your work is not that great, so what? Keep on doing it. That's why it's your motivation. You guys put that to yourselves, not for anybody else. And if you want somebody to critique your work, be okay and accept their flaws or whatever the case may be, because that's what you're asking for is critique. If not, if you're just going to give it out, then give it out. Like, that's the beauty of art. It doesn't have to make sense. It's your language to speak through colors, through paint, through pencil, whatever your art may be. That's how you speak through your life to other people. That's how you inspire other people. And that's my way of inspiring my friends, my coworkers, my family with my stress and anxiety. I do it on a piece of paper. I'll give it to you. And that little picture of, that you'll see, all you'll see is like, oh my God, this is beauty. The way I see it is like, man, I remember I was mad that day at my sister, or I had the situation with my brother.
Why gotta be me? Why gotta be me, mad at?
You know, that's how you get there. And I really appreciate you guys, whoever support me on, you know, Instagram or not, but whoever is there looking at my work, hey guys, like, I'm saying this right now, it's not me. I don't have the ability to draw something from my mind. I have to see something. And then I add my little touch to it. And after I add my little touch to it, hopefully it inspires other people. But that's what drives me to art.
Well, there you have it. We can actually cut from beginning of ending of his speaking and actually make it into a motivational seminar. 8-track? Do people have 8-track players anymore? No, I'm just kidding.
Imagine.
Yeah, we'll put you on YouTube, man. Well, speaking of artists, actually, if you can tell, right up here in the front, we have some pretty blank space on the table. And I thought, why not give an opportunity for some artists? Now, if you want to be a part of this running, you totally could be, Eli. But I think you missed your window of opportunity, because out of like 12 people that said they were interested, I came up with the idea, and only 2 capitalized on it. They're in the midst of their artwork right now. We want to put some amazing The Matt Rock Show painting or graffiti work or whatever colorful artwork we can come up with up here in the front. So there are 2 young, very talented artists that I am very excited to recognize on the show that we get to introduce their artwork. So we're going to have some beautiful The Matt Rock Show artwork. And it's an amazing opportunity for those artists to have their work displayed here on the show on NBC News Radio, KCAA, YouTube, The Matt Rock Show. So shout out to you both. Can't wait. I know I'm picking up one of the art pieces on Sunday. That's going to be pretty exciting. So it's not going to be so boring right there in front of us, but it's going to be pretty fun. Ooh. So let me go ahead and jump into my quote. My quote, the first one, is, and this is, of course, from the book, Do One Thing Every Day That Scares You, a journal of many proverbs and quotes and motivational ideas. Here we go. To those who need encouragement, remember this. Beware of quitting too soon. Dr. Seuss's first children's book was rejected by 23 publishers. The 24th publisher sold 6 million copies by Ann Landers. So why does that speak to me? Well, right now, I always will be, but I'm the managing member, 100% owner of Solid Rock Investors, which is my company. It's a limited liability company, and basically I flip houses. And in a later episode in the season, you're going to learn more about my business and what I do. I've never shared about that really live publicly like this, but anyway, in my business, I do a lot of things in business to grow the business, to get myself out there that a lot of people wouldn't do. It's very, unattractive. It's not exciting. It's not energizing. I'm showing up on doorsteps to people that are in pre-foreclosure. They're about to lose their home at a trustee sale, and they have so many people that are so abrasive and so negative and coming at them from all different kinds of angles. You should have paid your bills. You should have done this, X, Y, Z. And then here I show up, and my intention is to be kind, to let them know that they have options. Whether they want to save their home, whether they want to sell it, what I focus on is buying homes, of course. But not to get too far into the logistics, but this week especially, I've been out there like late at night. I was in the hood the other night. It was freezing. It was dark. And I shot up some prayers. That always gets me through. But it was cool. I got to talk to some people in the hood. I went to some other nicer neighborhoods, some middle-income neighborhoods. And no matter where it is, there are people that need help. And I want to be somebody that helps them. But back to the point of the quote is I'm showing up on doorsteps, and people are telling me to go away. People don't answer. I leave material for them to know that I'm here for them, and sometimes they get back to me and sometimes they don't. And last night, somebody just invited me into their house to kick it with their kids. They were like 1 and 2 years young, and sit on the carpet and hang out and talk. And it's just so interesting. Bless you.
Excuse me.
So interesting to see the different dynamics of people and how they really respond in a situation that does present a lot of pressure and stress. But man, I'm going around in circles here. To those who need encouragement, remember this. Beware of quitting too soon. I haven't had a lot of, let's call it success, right? Monetary success in this business yet, because it does take a lot of getting out there. It takes a lot of having people slam doors in your faces. It's not a super attractive business in a way. But it excites me to know that, especially when the going gets tough, right? Gets a little rough and you're being, let's call it, denied. You know, you have an opportunity. Can I help you? And they say no, whatever it is. I've been told that so many times over the past few weeks. And, I haven't had that yes yet, buy my house. It's because I haven't seen enough people. And imagine if I were to quit, but that next person that I were to talk to said, I've been praying for you. And you know what's so funny? I'm not going to say his name, but there was a guy that gave me a call. He said, look, I arrived at home after work and I saw your postcard on my gate. And I saw your business card, Solid Rock Investors. I know what Solid Rock means. He's a Christian as well. And that spoke to him. And he said, there are so many letters in my house. I've been so down and out. And I didn't want to open any of them. But when I saw your company and I knew the meaning and the purpose, I knew I had to give you a call. And I was the first one he called. And then he told me, he said, I've been praying for you. I prayed 2 days before you came, God, send me somebody that can help me in this situation, whether I have to save my home or I have to let it go. So either way, we're going to help them. So that inspires me. That inspires me. And we just want to encourage you, whether it's business, relationship, and dating. I know a lot of people are great and struggle at different areas of their lives. And it could be family. It could be personal development, growth, education. Once again, to those who need encouragement, remember this. Beware of quitting too soon. Dr. Seuss's first children's book was rejected by 23 publishers. By the 24th publisher sold 6 million copies by Ann Landers. So let's briefly go ahead and dive into these last quotes that we have. April, what is your second quote that you chose from the book?
The second quote kind of goes along with yours a little bit. The greatest pleasure in life is doing what people say you cannot do. And this is Walter Bagehot. From personal experience, for those of you who don't know me, I am a single parent. I have been for 6 years. And it took me a while to kind of realize that, I've made a lot of mistakes and I've done a lot of things that I probably shouldn't have done, but I learned from them and I did things that people never thought I would be able to do. And so that has been something that's kept me motivated to know that it feels good to know that you have this perseverance, like this drive that makes you keep moving forward. So you do what you want to do, regardless of what other people say, you know, the no's, that you can't, that you never will, that, oh, you're a single parent, you're not going to be able to do this or that, or how are you going to be able to work and go to school? How are you going to complete your dreams? You can't do that, you know? And so I thank God for people like you in my life, my brother, my family, some of my closer friends who actually encourage me. But I had a lot of people telling me, oh, you're not going to finish your bachelor's. You're not going to finish high school. You're not going to finish your master's. You know, your kids are going to be at-risk kids. But I'm so thankful that I have been able to just grace and favor. You know, God's grace and favor has opened up so many doors of opportunities for me and for my life. And it is a great pleasure to do things that people say you can't do, to prove them wrong, and then to say, well, you know, you don't believe in my God, but my God does this. You know, he does this for me and for other people, you know, not just myself, for my brother, my mom. You know, we all have that in our family. So again, the quote is, the greatest pleasure in life is doing what people say you cannot do. And that was by Walter Bagehot.
Rock on. Thank you. And Eli, what is your second quote? And why does that speak to you?
Well, before I get into this quote, I do want to share something with you guys. This quote has to do with not only biblical, but also with a lot of spirituality when it comes to the word love. Everybody loves a definition of love. Everybody has their own definition of what love is.
I love love.
And, you know, we all love
love.
Me too.
Love.
So before I get into this, I just want to let you guys know, just take it with a grain of salt. Some people might enjoy this. Some people may not. And I'll explain why I like this quote. So being deeply loved by someone gives you strength, while loving someone deeply gives you courage. That's by Lao Tzu, I think I pronounced it right. It's T-Z-U. Now, the reason why that quote speaks so much to me is that there is a very difficult time in our lives where my mother was diagnosed with cancer. My uncle passed away. We were surrounded by death. And I was trying so hard in my life to be very positive during this time. And I was trying to be the stepping stone in my family for my mom. I was trying to be so tough for her and be there for her. I was working several jobs. April was working like crazy. We did everything we could to really survive, but it was really by our faith and by love. And what I mean by the first part, being deeply loved by someone gives you strength, that was my mother. My mother was on the bed. She was the one looking at us, giving us encouragement, telling us, hey, Eli, I love you, mijo. You're going to be okay. And giving April motivation, mija, you're going to be all right. And she was the one always giving us that motivation every single time. And when it seems, and the other part of the quote, while loving someone deeply gives you courage, I love my mom. She was the one person in our lives that through all the difficult things, she was the one being strong for us. How ironic is this? We're the children. We're supposed to be the motivation. Mom, you're going to be okay. And we visit her every single night in the hospital. My dad's staying in the hospital for weeks on end. And the first thing that she does, hey, baby, how was work? And she was always smiling. No matter how much pain she was in, no matter how much struggle that she personally had throughout the day or my dad, the first thing that she said when we walked into that room was, I love you, mijo. How was your day? And those simple words move me still to this day. So to go back around to the quote, being deeply loved by someone gives you strength, while loving someone deeply gives you courage. That's by Lao Tzu. And that quote itself, I hope you guys know that these are things that we need to believe, not even in the word of God, but love is the strength that keeps on going through. You know, in this world, even the Bible says that the whole world would end, but love will always be there. You know, I love my hermanita, I love my sister April, I love my family. And through this love, that's how we've been gone to where we're at today. That's why Matt's right here owning on his show, TheMattRockShow.com. You know, this is why he's working so hard and being motivational to his friends, his peers. You know, he's doing Herbalife and he's so fit. There's so many things about our lives now that he's getting to where
show
he's
it,
at.
Show the muscle.
Flex.
This guy.
He's flexing. So this guy right here in itself, because of this love that we have as a family, as brothers, as sisters, as Christ, whatever you want to call it, this is where we're at today. We're motivating each other throughout the daily basis. I remember so many times when I was down, Matt would call me. He'd be like, Eli, what's going on? And I'd throw my little tantrum and freak out. And you know what he does?
Because he's little. He's like,
a little tantrum.
That's why he throws tantrums.
You know what he says? He says, Eli, I'm going to pray for you, brother. He would read me a quote, pray for me, and say, look, man, we're going to be all right. And vice versa. I do the same thing for him. That's what you would call love. You know, there's no hindrance of what love is. You guys have your own definition or whatever that may be, but I hope that this quote speaks to you in more ways than one.
Man, well, drop your mic if you could. So very, very quickly, segue into just to bring in some joy here. While other children were playing in sand, Chuck Norris was playing in concrete. And Chuck Norris once heard that nothing can kill him, so he tracked down nothing and killed it.
But I'm bumped.
Now, while you were saying everything you were saying, I was feeling it because I've been there for the most part, you know, in and out. I'd come down and I'd visit you guys every weekend for the most part.
No, you were great. You were great support to
us.
Do you know, I wish you would see my mom's face when you walked into that room. Her eyes lit up. She didn't see Matt. She saw her son. And she didn't see, oh, this is just Eli's friend. This is, oh, this is my baby. So I wish you would have seen how she looks at you, man, because she sees you as her son. And
she's so proud of you.
She's so proud of the hard work that you've done. She's so proud of the man that you've become.
We are proud of you.
I mean, all of us are. I mean, absolutely. But you should see how my mom always speaks so highly about you. It's because of these things that we speak to life. Matthew's going to do great. Matthew's going to be great. And here we are.
I would group hug you guys if I could.
Group hug?
Group hug.
Yeah, group hug. There we go.
There we go.
There we go. Now, I love my mother so much, and I'm grateful to be the son of my mom. And God has also blessed me with incredible mother-like figures in my life. And Martha Garcia is one of those women, and I am so grateful. So we love you, Martha. We love you, Mom.
You're awesome. Okay.
So thank you for who you are. And thank you, guys. I really appreciate it. So really quick. So when you were speaking and everything like that, I was feeling it. But at the same time, I was looking and saying, all right, which Chuck Norris jokes am I going to say next? So I kind of like chuckled, but I wasn't chuckling at what you were saying. And because I kind of
wanted. He was so inspired, he didn't even realize that you were laughing.
Yeah, he was going in. And Chuck Norris jokes make me cry laughing sometimes. So if I cry, don't mind it. But we'll probably say a couple of Chuck Norris jokes. I have this book, 100 Facts on Chuck Norris, and it's just the best thing ever. But we're going to go through it on this phone. Chuck Norris, I don't know if you knew this, but this is real life. This is a true story.
Word.
Word.
Word. Chuck
Norris. Use the voice. Use the voice.
Baby.
Chuck Norris makes fire by rubbing two ice cubes together.
Ooh.
I don't know why you guys don't think this is that funny. Like, I was over here, like,
because I'm trying to think about the two ice cubes and the lighting fire. Wouldn't it melt before that happened?
No, it just doesn't make sense. Why are you guys so logical?
I mean, you're talking about two artists who are logical? I mean, no, 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 no.
When his fingers get cold, or is it so cold that it's hot?
When Chuck Norris was born, he drove his mom home from the hospital. I don't know how Chuck Norris made that happen, but Chuck Norris can also slam a revolving door. That's my favorite of all time.
He can slam a revolving door.
Okay, you guys are too logical for this to be funny. I don't think about it logically.
How about Clint
Eastwood? That makes no sense. It's a good time.
Here's your magnum.
My second favorite Chuck Norris joke is,
do you feel lucky?
Chuck Norris. I do.
Do you?
Punk.
Together.
Chuck Norris was born in the same log cabin that he built with his bare hands.
Oh my. Drop mic. Ladies
drop
and gentlemen.
Phone. No, don't drop it. It's already cracked enough. Okay. All right. We're going to go with one more, and then we'll probably segue into a brief welcome into the show for those that are just tuning in. Let's see. Chuck Norris invented Chuck Norris jokes, but he never submitted any because Chuck Norris submits to no one. Okay. All right, we're done.
Pause.
We're done.
I was thinking of different types of submit.
All right, so moving on. Carlos, hopefully we can get this right. I think we're 6 for 6 so far. But if you guys are just tuning into the show, we here at the Matt Rock Show want to say,
welcome to the Matt Rock Show. Welcome to the Matt Rock Show. Welcome to the welcome to the welcome to the welcome to the welcome 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 welcome.
Yeah, if you're just tuning in on the radio or on the MattRockShow.com or KCAAradio.com, we want to say welcome to the Matt Rock Show. And I don't know if you saw my terrible dab. I need to get more emphatic with it. But
what's a dab?
What is it? Boom.
Oh, dang. Sorry, I'm old.
Dab with me, audience.
Dab.
There we go.
Yeah, I suck at that.
Yeah, mine's like a 4 out of 10.
I like this one better.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and kind of dive into my last quote with our Solid Rock Talk segment. Solid Rock Talk. And what we're going to do after that is dive into kind of how we met. We're going to have a fun time with that.
Oh, geez.
And then after that, if we have some time, if we don't talk forever, an hour goes by so quick on this show.
Kind of
I
does.
Wish we had all
And
that.
You're here with the family, man.
Goes by even faster.
Man. So hopefully we get into Sing or Sync, which is a brand new game.
I think Eli's trying to avoid it.
Yeah, so.
Oh, yeah.
Shout out to Mama Johnson. Hi, we love you. And you guys got to meet her tonight. And she
awesome.
Had given me an idea. She had a dream about a segment called Off the Wall. And I was like, I don't know what we can do with that. Like
Michael Jackson, Off the Wall.
Yeah, probably have you do some Michael Jackson dancing soon. But I thought, why not create a fun game? I really like Jimmy Fallon. Is it The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon? Yes. That's one of my favorite talk shows. Mm-hmm. And they have fun, goofy games. So I thought, why not create one? But thank you for the inspiration, Mama. So we'll get into that soon. All right, my last quote. And let's finish up this solid rock talk segment. Here we go. Think you can, think you can't. Either way, you'll be right. Woo! By Henry Ford. So I'm going to say it again. Think you can, think you can't. Either way, you'll be right.
Wow.
Lately, I've been listening day in and day out. I'm doing this 30-day test, and I don't believe in The Secret, really the law of attraction. I do believe that who you are, you're attracting certain things, but most of all, we who believe in the guy that we believe in, we're not pressing anything on anybody, but we do believe that we are blessed with circumstances, with people coming into our lives. In one way, I attracted you guys, but God blessed me with you guys in my life, and vice versa, I believe.
Of course.
So more than the law of attraction, I believe it is The Secret Things from God, which is actually a book that I have that was recommended to me by my girlfriend, Lindsay, and that's just been a turning point in my life coming to this idea. But it really does say in the Bible, you become what you think about.
Yes.
And I've been listening to Earl Nightingale, Day In and Day Out, a 30-minute segment, basically on the strangest secret in the world. And the strangest secret in the world really comes down to, and you can go on YouTube and type that in, the strangest secret in the world. Listen to it and come up with your own 30-day test. I'm in the midst of it. I think it's day like 14 tomorrow. It's a good time, and I'm progressing. But anyway, we become what we think about all day long. And whether you think failure, you become failure. Whether you think success, you become success. And what is success? The version that Earl Nightingale says that somebody else had inspired him to come up with was really the realization of a worthy ideal. If you want to be a high school teacher and you love doing that, you love providing value, if you're doing that, you are a successful person because you're doing exactly what you set your heart, your goals, and your mind to.
Right.
But anyway, this quote is going to really divert into our next segment of chat, which is really about how we met. But think you can, think you can't. Either way, you're right. So when I was in acting class in college at Here we go.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Jesus.
Let's get this started.
Woo. All right. This should be a good time.
Get ready.
We have
for
20
a good
minutes.
Time.
Okay. We're going to dive through this really quick. That way we get into Sing or Sink, okay?
All right.
So here we go. In college, I had a girl in the class that said, hey, I'm doing Aladdin. I'm in this play called Aladdin. You know what it is. And we want to cast you as Aladdin. I said, what? Because I was just in acting class just for fun, just to get out of my comfort zone. She said, come on down. The director wants you to come and check it out. So I go down and just, I was terrified, but I did it anyway. So I basically auditioned for Aladdin, and they said, yes, we want you to play Aladdin, which doesn't make sense. You look at me, I don't look like Aladdin. I don't sound like him either, but I had the part. The next day, auditions are still open, and this little guy comes
in. That was my
in.
Fault, though. I brought him. I forced him.
That's true, because April as well was in Aladdin, playing one of the ladies of the show. And anyway, he comes in looking just like Aladdin. He might as well have had the little purple cap on his head.
For the record, that was intentionally. I came in with a white shirt, hair, you know, just like long at Aladdin. All I had to do was just do a little hair swear, you know, back and forth.
Now, we had to read.
Code read.
I think I won that one. I think he told me that. The kids loved me, and they were like, who is this little guy that's our height? And they were like four, by the way. Eli's really short. We love Matt Rock. And who's this little guy coming to play Aladdin? Whatever. I won the cold reading. I take pride in that. And then we had to sing in front of everybody. Ugh. Now, one of my fears, and this one of my fears.
our fears.
this is really going to segue into our Sing or Sink. But one of my fears is singing publicly. Right now, though, it's just us chilling in the studio with Carlos, our engineer. Really, we're being watched live all over the world. And my fear is singing publicly.
Period.
So we're not going to go full-style karaoke a little bit later. We're going to play some songs. We'll sing with them. But we're going to face that fear. But back to when I met this guy, they said, all right, here's a song. Now, this was the Aladdin before the Aladdin that we all know. This
Aladdin
was the original
and his magical
Aladdin.
Lamp.
back in like 1991.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So anyway, we had to sing a certain song. Now, there weren't words played. They said, here's the instrumental. You have 5 minutes to learn it, and then you're going to sing it in front of 50 people. And we had to belt it out. And boy, did I win. Yes, that's one of the trophies of my life. I beat
pale.
You in this.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. See, I beat you on the code read. I beat you looking like Aladdin. Mm. But when it came to singing, man, you belched that song so well. Looking at them, I'm like, what?
And I'm not a singer, but I think next to you, I look like Marvin Gaye. Like Marvin Gaye or something. So anyway.
God, yes.
So he ended up getting the spot as Aladdin. The director said, Matt, we got to push you to a different role. And I was really just unpersonally developed, very selfish, and I got upset. I mean, I don't
you
act.
My
I don't
bits.
Do anything.
Okay.
And nobody liked him, but because he stole my spot. Yeah, you're a sister. So
I don't have to.
So moving forward, after like a week or so, we really began creating a really, really amazing, fun friendship. Mm-hmm. And then
it originated from Disney?
And it did. And we became brothers pretty much right away. And I came to the house and I met the rest of Familia. And I don't even say that right. I have such a white boy accent.
Familia.
Thank you.
Familia.
Goodness gracious. Wait till we name one of the song titles later.
Yeah, you're going to say it.
And so then fast forward to when we actually go. And it's a play that we had at a theater that's right up from my house in Fontana. So night one, night two, night three, it gets like better and better and better by night.
It started bad, then it went from better to so it went bad, better, and then to like, all right.
You guys have a terrible way of thinking. I thought it was fantastic all three nights.
Because there's always something wrong with
You're
the
such
show.
A positive
it was always
person.
One thing or another.
I am. You know what? I thought it was fun, and I thought we made it work, and maybe it wasn't perfect, but we didn't have a lot of time to put it together either.
Touché.
And then everybody was on their feet, mm-hmm. you know, even with little mistakes and stuff. I don't think the audience knew. I think we knew because we knew what we were doing, but right. the audience really didn't care.
Yeah, nope. They did.
Yeah, I never knows what you're
positive
doing.
Thinking. Didn't you just say that?
And that's up in the quote.
And
right.
Yeah. And
positive
all off, we
were thinking. I think it was great.
And to top it off, we were working with kids. We were working with kids.
Little
so they're like,
but the kids were amazing.
Yes, they were.
We were all amazing.
So earlier, your brother brought up and reminded us of this one time. And okay, so my quote and how I can kind of tie this in is whether you think you can, whether you think you can't, you're right, right?
Word.
So here's the thing. In life, some things happen. And when you're live on a play and you're the main character, I ended up playing Chop Chop the Executioner, by the way, and I wore a vest with no shirt. So
he
I had
looked
my
very
abs.
Good.
Flexing.
I didn't have
the
abs at
time.
That time. Thank you.
He still looked very good.
I wish I did. I was on an Herbalife at that time, but I thought I had it going on. That shows you how cocky and not going on I had it.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Anyway, so Ruben had reminded us of basically
my younger brother Ruben.
At some part of the show, Jasmine, the lead character, along with you, had said what and how did that go? And take like 30 seconds on this. We got to move on.
I'll make it very quickly. So there's a line that says, "The spotlight is on me. Everything is on me." And one of the lines is supposed to say, "I'm supposed to make one last wish, and I'm rubbing the ring." And then the ring, I'm supposed to say, "Do it one more time for Aladdin." That was the quote. That was what I'm supposed to say. But I clench up. I get nervous, and I say, "One more time. Do it for Eli." And everybody starts laughing. Jasmine, instead of being quiet and playing along, you know what she says? She goes, "Who's Eli?" And then I have to think really quickly, man.
This is probably like 100 people.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh yeah, that's my nickname. And then everybody starts breaking down laughing, and we were able to play it off smoothly. But that moment, I had to improvise so much because I was so anxious. I was so nervous. And I'm saying, "Do it one more time for Aladdin." I'm saying, "Do it one more time for Eli." And everybody's cracking up. Like, who's Eli? You see everybody in the audience looking around like, who's Eli?
Isn't this that on tape. So if anybody wants to see it, send in requests.
And if you guys do want to see it, yeah, you guess what? I'm telling you right now, it's priceless. It's hilarious.
Man. I kind of don't want to look at the photos, man. But that was a great time in our lives. So that was actually how I came to know both of them. And you both are rocks in my life. So I love you both. Thank you for everything you've ever been and done and been in my life. So thank you.
We're going to continue if you allow us to.
Hell yeah. likewise. So let's move on. Now, this new game is called Sing or Sink.
Oh,
Eli
God.
Is so ready for this. We
he
have
is.
15
He's
minutes
ready.
To rock out. So,
come on, Eli.
What we're going to do is we're going to popcorn this bad boy. Okay. Now, I'm going to say sing or sink once we come up with a song. And then whoever is down is going to say sing. And they're going to sing it. Now, we're going to play the words. We're not going full-out karaoke. We're going to wait until we go to the karaoke bar sometime soon. That's next level. But we're going to sing, and you guys are going to hear us. We're going to have a good time. If you know the song, sing with us. Have
Please.
A good time. This is really, especially for Eli, facing
Look, I got to say, I can't sing. I can act. I can look
None
pretty.
None of us can sing.
It's okay. None of us can sing.
None of
we
us
got
can
this.
Sing.
We
but we're
going
to have a good time anyway. And
Enjoy.
We're doing this. the intention of this is, number one, to have fun, because the Matt Rock Show is all about not only motivating and empowering and supporting and all this fun stuff, amazing motivational positive stuff, but having fun in life. And we're going to do that. And we're all about facing fears and encouraging people to sing as if nobody's listening.
Ooh, oh,
dance like nobody's watching, but sing as if nobody's listening.
I can
so,
dance like nobody's
popcorn,
watching.
Popcorn, here we go. All right, April, I'm going to have you dive in and pick one. Pick one, bring it out, and go ahead and name the song. Now, we're not going to sing the full song unless it's...
Eli.
Oh, boy.
What is it?
You have to say it, Matt.
Oh, no, no, no. I don't know how to say
you
that.
You can say it. Come on.
El Aventurero.
El Aventurero.
Okay, so, Carlos, if you could play that, I'm going to sit out, and these two are going to sing
God. Go, Eli.
Say
oh,
it.
Oh, Lord.
I need the words.
Oh. Sing. You're singing.
We're singing. We're singing. Right. We're going to sing.
Oh, good Lord.
Where are you guys at?
Right there. Ay la la la, ay la la la, ay la 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 la, ay la la la, ay la la la, ay la 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 la. Yo soy el aventurero. El mundo me importa poco. Cuando una mujer me gusta a pesar de todos.
If I spoke Spanish, I would so join you guys. You guys ready to move to the next song?
Yeah,
all right, let's pick the next song. All right, we're gonna stop that one. That was so good.
We butchered it. I'm sorry.
No, we didn't even get to the good part.
That was so good. Okay, Eli, pick one. And then name the title of the song in the mic, and let's see who it's for.
Ladies and gentlemen, the song you're about to listen to
is
Your Man. And Matthew Rock. Sing or sing.
Play it a little louder.
Are you going to sing?
My gosh.
Sing or sing.
You guys, I don't know how to sing. Don't hold me to this.
Are you going to sing?
Tell you
I am
what?
So nervous right now.
You can do this. We believe in you.
Do you?
Yes, we just butchered a very famous Hispanic song. You can do this.
You're going to sing this song with your heart.
All right.
Baby, lock them door and turn the lights down low.
Ooh.
Put some music on this soft and slow. Baby, we ain't got no place to go. I hope you understand.
Where's the candles?
I've been thinking about this all day long. I never felt a feeling quite this strong.
And he says he can't sing.
I can't believe how much it turns me on.
I know.
I practiced.
Just to be your man.
I saw this black guy on X Factor that was killing it.
Oh, man.
Don't hurry. Don't you worry.
And it inspired me.
We can take our time.
So he was my inspiration today. He was 17.
My daughter loves the song.
Let's go over what I had in mind. Baby, lock them door and turn the lights down low. And put some music on it soft and slow. Baby, we ain't got no place to go.
If you look
at
my face,
you understand.
It's very
I've been thinking about this all day long.
All right, we're on to the next song. That was fun.
Okay.
That was good. Hey, you know what? For someone who says who can't sing, you
sound pretty good.
Man, you sound Thank very you. Well, man.
I took my girlfriend's advice, and I said, what should I stick to? She says, stick to country pop. So
stick
thank
what
you,
know.
Lindsay. Aww. I appreciate you. Okay, all right, popcorn. I get to choose one.
Yes.
That was
Yay.
Fun. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. That was very nerve-wracking.
Nerve-wracking.
Oh,
what.
Snap, Everything by Michael Bublé. I'm singing? Singing?
I'm singing.
Yes,
singing.
I'm singing.
Singing?
I'm singing, yes.
Okay.
Might as well.
Might as well.
Turn up a little bit more. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Check it. Check it. Listen, girl.
You're a falling star.
Where are you at, April?
I don't know. I'm looking for the lyrics. I'm looking for
the
lyrics.
Light in the sand when I go too far. You're a swimming pool on an August day. And you're the perfect thing to say. And you play it coy, but it's kind of cute. Oh, when you smile at me, you know exactly what you do. Baby, don't consent. If you don't know it's true.
This guy doesn't know the words, but it's okay. It's so
it's
fun.
Okay. Neither
it's
do so I.
And in this crazy life, and through these crazy times, it's you, it's you. You make me sing. You're every line. You're every word. You're everything.
All right, next song. All right, what else
God,
we got?
I just got the line. I just got the words.
Man, you should have been prepared.
I was right. not prepared.
We were April? So not prepared for this show.
No, we weren't.
My phone was slow.
Hey. All right, let's see. Okay,
what we got next?
Good
what we got
time.
Next?
We just played a Michael Bublé song. I think we should play another one. Okay. Well, we'll keep it short.
I like Michael Bublé.
Haven't met you yet.
Ooh, oh,
do you have the lyrics yet, April?
I do.
Get it.
Sing along with us, guys. We're having a good time. We're not singers.
Everybody out there, I hope you guys are enjoying
this. So don't sing at me. What's up, Tim Johnson?
Hey, I hope you guys out there having a good time. I'll tell you this. This is the most nerve-wracking thing for me. If you guys are hearing me, just laugh, please.
Oh, enjoy this. Such a good time.
Haven't
met you yet.
Got it.
All right.
Got it.
Are you ready?
Yes.
All right.
You got it, Carlos?
Oh, he's getting it. All right.
Oh, he pulling it up. Mm. So in the meantime, I wish I had Chuck Norris jokes.
No, we're too analytical, remember?
Remember?
Here we go.
He's no funny.
Bigfoot claims he saw Chuck Norris. All right, here we go. Oh, you were so ready for that.
Actually, ready.
You were so ready. Here we go.
I like the song.
I'm not surprised, not everything you ask. I've broken my heart so many times, I stopped keeping track. I talk myself in, I talk myself out. I get all worked up and I let myself down. I tried so very hard not to lose it. I came up with a million excuses. I thought of every possibility.
Who doesn't know the song now?
And I know someday that it'll all turn up. You'll make me work to make it work to work it out. And I promise you, kid, that I'll get so much more than I get. I just haven't met you yet.
All right, next song. Eli over here should be on American Idol.
Oh. Man, please.
Man, that's why I shut up. That's why I shut up.
Ain't nobody for
this. Killing it. You were killing it, man. Oh, this is
not
too
fun. Not
in
a good way.
Okay. Oh, all right. This is for Eli and I. Andy Grammer, Fine by Me.
Ooh.
Eli, let's go.
I don't even know half of these songs.
Play that loud.
Yeah. Check it.
You're not the type of girl to remain with the guy too shy, too afraid to say he'll give his heart to you forever. I'm not the boy that will fall to his knees. Begging you please to stay with him for worse or for better. But I'm staring at you now, there's no one else around. I'm thinking you're the girl for me. I'm just saying it's fine by me if you never leave. And we can live like this forever, it's fine by me. In the past, I would try hard to commit to a girl, wouldn't get too far, but it always somehow seemed to fall apart.
That's okay, you don't know the words. That's cool, man. We sing this all the time.
Will you?
I can see that.
Realistically, knew this dance was different from the start.
All right, next song.
You guys did great. Oh, that sounded amazing.
Eli, you inspire me. Getting you home.
Ooh.
Getting you home.
Is that you?
I guess this is for me.
Oh, he's singing.
What's up, Lindsay?
It's for you.
Tuxedo waiter, black tie, white tablecloths, and red wine. We've been planning this night, looking forward to it for some time. Now, honey, I know you love getting dressed up, and you know I love showing you off, but watching your baby blue eyes
put fire on me.
Dancing in the candlelight glow.
Super hot fire.
Because I spit hot fire.
All I can think about is getting you home. Walking through the front door, seeing your black dress hit the floor. Honey, there sure ain't nothing like you loving me all night long. And all I can think about,
tell me what you're thinking about,
is getting you home, Eli.
Oh, just kidding. Pause. All right, next song. So that's it for Sing or Sync, and we didn't really follow the rules of the game. We didn't choose a Sing or Sync. We just sang.
We just sang.
I mean, look, we came here to fight our fears. You're saying, you sang, man, I sang,
so
April sang.
Fun.
You know what?
High five. Hey, look, high five. High five.
Slide this way.
There
you know what?
All right, I think we have one more treat for you guys. This should be fun.
Uh-oh.
So April, are you ready to get down with me for for Aladdin.
I'm always down. With you, Matt. Always down.
In remembrance of...
Keyword, down.
Us, me... We're family, stop that. We met many years ago on the set of Aladdin.
Yes.
And that's one thing. The second thing is I thought this would just be fun.
The third thing is
I've wanted to sing this publicly. We're not singers, but no, we want to have fun with this.
If you couldn't tell, we're not.
And I chose Eli for this part. He was going to play, of course, Jasmine. But he wasn't down.
Every time,
he
just for you.
He wasn't down. Thank you. So, April... Thank you for stepping up.
Ali.
We're going to play a little Aladdin.
That's right. I stepped up.
We're going to experience a whole new world. So let's do this, April. A whole new world. Aladdin.
I can show you the world. Shining, shimmering.
Why are you singing with this? My part. Get out of here. You said no.
Princess, no way. Let your heart decide. I can open your eyes.
He's a hype man.
Take you wonder by wonder.
Wonder.
Over, sideways, and under. On a magic carpet ride. A whole new world. A new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no. Or where to go. Or say we're only dreaming.
A whole new world.
Oh my.
A dazzling place I never knew. But when I'm way up here, it's crystal clear. Now I'm in a whole new world with you.
Now I'm in a whole new world with you.
Unbelievable sights. Indescribable feelings. Soaring, tumbling, freewheeling through an endless diamond sky, a whole new world.
Don't you dare close your eyes. Hold your breath, it gets better.
I'm like a shooting star. I've come so far. I can't go back to where I used to be. Every turn a surprise.
With new horizons.
Every moment, red letters.
I'll chase them anywhere. There's time to spare. Let me share this whole new world with you. A whole new world.
A whole new world.
That's where we'll be.
That's where we'll be.
A thrilling chase.
A wondrous place.
Listen, girl.
For you and me.
I wish you guys were all listening to this. Please, round of applause for these people. Come on, that was great.
You scared me when you put your hand over my face. I was not expecting that because my eyes were closed.
I've waited all my life for that. Don't you dare close your eyes. But I didn't prep you for that beforehand.
No, you didn't. Wow. No, you didn't.
Okay.
That was a genuine.
So what we're going to do is we're going to close out the show. I wish we had another hour, you guys. thank you so much, Eli. April, for being on the show.
Thank you. I love you.
You are my family.
Thank you very much.
I hope some aspect of this show really inspired you, really entertained you tonight and motivated you. Whatever you enjoyed about this show, share with it on your Facebook, your Instagram, Snapchat. Shoot us a text.
Yep.
Go to themattrockshow.com for more episodes
to see
what's going on next week. We thank you so much for enjoying this hour with us and help us. My hype man over here.
Help us take
this around the world, you guys. So I'm Matt Rock.
Share.
This is Eli Garcia.
Eli Hazel Garcia.
We thank you so much for being a part of this amazing global motivation entertainment project.
It was a pleasure and
welcome
honor.
To the Matt Rock Show. Take us with you in 2017.
Lots
Have a good
love.
One, you guys. Bump it.
Love, peace, and grease.
Welcome to the Matt Rock Show.
When you're in your mind with nowhere to go, well then welcome to the Matt Rock Show. Welcome to the Matt Rock Show. Show. Welcome to the Matt Rock Show. Welcome to the welcome to the Matt Rock Show.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM. KCAA Loma Linda. Listen on 1050.